So good morning, dear students. We were doing this chapter, Kingdom of Fools, and we were supposed to discuss question answer. This chapter was done. So today we will be discussing question answer, and I want maximum participation of you. Okay. So question number one we have is, what are the two strange things the guru and his disciple find in the kingdom of fools? So question number one. What strange things did they find there? What strange things did they find there? Tell me. Hurry up, start finding this answer. First thing, that day was considered night, and night was considered
day.
And second, everything was available in the market at same price. What was the unit of price at that time? Yes. So Daljeet, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. The guru and the disciple found many strange things. They saw that everyone was actually in the broad daylight. Even a mouse was not there. When the evening, they wandered around the town till evening. When suddenly the whole town woke up, and the two men felt hungry. Now the shops were open. They went to buy some groceries. They were astonished to see that the price was same for everything. They bought everything in a single doo-doo and filled their stomach for a 1 rupee.
Very good. Perfect. Now, Simran, you tell me the same answer. Simran.
Yes, ma'am. The kingdom of fools lived, the name kingdom of the fools lived up to his name. This is because the minister, the kings, and everyone there were all fools. They didn't know how to act or make any decision. All their brains were opposite from the other normal people. When the guru and the disciple found the place, they saw that everything was opposite. People used to work during nights and sleep during days, and everything was cheap and cost the same.
Okay. Now, same answer, Dhiren, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. The two strange things, the guru and disciple.
You people will be
the two strange things.
Let's speak.
The two strange things that the guru and his disciple find in the kingdom of fools was that when they first entered the kingdom, they saw that all the people were, no one was there in the great afternoon. But as this evening set down, they saw people starting going out of the work, and as the day was becoming dark, people were starting their work. This was very contrary to their everyday experience, as they saw that people would start work at the morning, but the town started the work at evening because of the order of the king, who was a fool. Second, they saw that everything was can be taken as a cost of doo-doo, and they were able to take everything from rice to ghee and banana, and a bunch of banana which cost only a doo-doo. So they can buy everything in just a rupee.
Very good. Perfect answer. So two strange things were happening there. First, I have told you about the day and night concept. And second, the concept of price of everything. Okay. But you have to elaborate this answer in detail. Okay. Now let's move to second question. Why does the disciple decide to stay in the kingdom of fools? Is it a good idea? Tell me. it was a good idea or not. See, he was so greedy, so hungry. He wanted to attain each and everything at the lowest price, which was available. He wanted to eat to his fill. Even one day also he fell ill also. He got obesity. He became so fat. So it was good idea or not? Even Guru was not in the favor. He went against his Guru. Yes, Vanshika. It is disciple. Yes, one can fall ill after consuming so much food. So it was basically not a good idea. Moreover, his guru was also not with him. And he gave him warning that in this kingdom, very strange things can happen in the future also. So you should be aware of this thing. You should be aware of all these fools. You should not stay with them because it is not a right decision to stay in the company of fools. Clear? Okay, Renuka, you tell me same answer. Yes, Renuka. Renuka, you tell me same answer. Arzu, you tell me. Arzu, you tell me same answer. Yes, Arzu.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, good morning. Your answer is?
Yes, ma'am. The disciple decides to stay in the kingdom of fools because everything was cheap in that kingdom. He wanted to have good and cheap food. No, it was not a good idea. The guru even warned the disciple that it was a kingdom of fools and it won't last very long. He said that one cannot tell what the people of this kingdom will do next.
Okay, good. So basically it was not a good idea at all. Now next question is, name all the people who are tired, who are tried in King's court and give the reason for their trial. See, there was a chain of that. First, who was called? Then, merchant blamed whom? Bricklayers. So, bricklayer blamed whom? Dancing girl. Dancing girl blamed whom? Gold. And goldsmith blamed whom? Merchants. So, there was a chain of that. So, who is going to explain that chain? Who is an intelligent student of my class? Jashan, You keep your video on. Jashan, keep your video on. Bricklayer. Okay, Raghav, you tell me this answer. Raghav. Okay, Ridhima, you tell me this answer. Ridhima.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. The owner of the house, that is the merchant, the bricklayer, the dancing girl, and the goldsmith were tired in the king's court. They all were tired because the thief died when the wall of merchant's house had collapsed. The merchant was tired for building a weak wall. The bricklayer was tired for doing his work carelessly. The dancing girl was tired for disturbing the concentration of the bricklayer. The goldsmith was blamed for making the dancing girl walk up and down to his house a dozen times.
Good. Very.
And these all people again and again make themselves clear to the king and make others as a culprit in front of him.
Good. So, Nitya, you tell me same answer. Which were jingling. Okay, so same answer. You tell me, Divyanshi. Divyanshi, you tell me same answer. This why your name is? Huh? Akhilesh, you tell me this answer. Your book there. So it is my duty to bring book from your house. You have to tell me the chain of all the culprits. Others have also told. You are not listening. Reza. Name all the people who are tried in King's court and give the reason for their trial. Bricklayer. Okay, next question we have is, who is the real culprit according to the king? Why does he escape punishment? So same answer you have to repeat. You have to tell all the story in nutshell. Then you have to elaborate at last, who is the real culprit, which was, you can say, conclusion was taken. Okay, because the merchant has taken all the things from his father. Okay. So if he has taken his property, so he should also take father's sin as well as. So according to the king, who was real culprit? According to the king, merchant was real culprit. But merchant was too thin to fit on the stake. Okay. So he escaped execution. So the king found out solution that the man who will be very much fat, according to that size, it will fit into the stake for final execution. Clear? So, so Arzu, you tell me this answer. Yes, Arzu. Yes, Arzu. Yes, Arzu. Tell me this answer. Yes, Arzu. You are being marked absent if you are not able to give me the answer. Unmute yourself. Ashmeet Kaur. Jashan. These students will be marked absent by me today. Jashan. Arzu, tell me this answer. Aryan Chopra, you tell me this answer. Ye Arzu, Aryan, pata kya kiya? Class on hai, but they are not found anywhere. Kahan bol rahi hai? Arzu, tell me this answer. Aryan. Yes, connect. Aryan Chopra, Daljeet, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. According to the foolish king, the merchant was real culprit. He escaped punishment because he was very much thin to be fit into this stake. So he ordered to found the fat person to be fit in the stake, and his soldiers found the disciple to be fit in the stake.
Good. Now next question we have is, what are the guru's words of wisdom? When does the disciple remember them? What are the guru's words of wisdom? Yes, Kavarnur, you tell me this answer.
The guru word of wisdom was that this was the city of
Very good. Because what were the words of his guru? Guru said that it is a kingdom of fool. You don't know, because such kind of funny decisions, such kind of silly decisions has been taken by a king and a minister. They are considering day as night, night as day. That is a very foolish decision they have taken. And they are, you can say, made, they have made a rule that everything is, the market is available at same price. So that is also a very foolish decision. Okay, so he says that no, there is no need to stay in that place, because in future what will happen, you never know. So you should be aware of this thing, and that's why you should know, you should not stay in the kingdom of fools. So these were the wise words said by Guru. And afterwards, what happened? Good things were happened, or strange things were happened? Foolish. After that, foolish decisions were taken by king. So it was really lots of risk to stay in such kind of place. Okay. So same answer, Arzu. Arzu has decided to leave. She will not reply.
Yes.
Okay. Dhiren, yes, you tell. Yes, Arzu. Batao.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. The guru's word of wisdom were that it was a kingdom of fools. He advised their disciple to leave the city because he would not know what they would to be next. The disciple remembers this when he was going to be executed.
Okay.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, actually earlier na, there was no option coming to unmute myself, so that's why.
So you could send me a chat, message in chat box. You were not replying at all.
Ma'am, no, I'll send. No, ma'am, I'll send.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now Sahil Dhingra and Jashan. Jashan?
Ma'am, may I ask?
Jashan, keep yourself on mute and tell me answer. Jashan. Okay, Ridhima, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. The guru was full of wisdom and knew well that the unpredictable behavior of the fools could create danger anytime. The guru's words were, they are all fools. They won't last very long. And you can't tell what they will do to you next. This blind remembered them when he arrested by the men of the king to execute merely because he fitted the stake. It was because of the guru's words of wisdom that the execution was postponed.
Okay. Our next question is, how does the guru manage to save his disciples' life? Very good question. That how did he manage? When he was to be, when king decided to give punishment to that fat person, that he should be, you can say, hang on that stake. So guru came, he was just calling the name of guru. So guru came in front of him with his vision. He saw that his follower is in this. Okay, his life is in risk. So what decision has been, how did he manage? How did he manage? So from online students, Jayati, you tell me, how did he manage?
Yes, ma'am. Guru used his wisdom and magic powers to save his disciple's life. He reached the kingdom instantly when his disciple prayed in his heart for help. He first confused the kingdom, the king, by expressing his desire to be killed before, so that he could be the next king of the kingdom. They tricked the king in this way that it was the stake of the god of justice. And whoever would die first would become the king after rebirth. The second person to be executed would become the minister after rebirth. Ultimately, the king fell in his trap and set the guru and his disciple free. He got his minister and himself executed in their place. Hence, the guru not only saved his disciples' life, but also made the people get rid of the foolish king and his silly minister.
Okay. Same answer. Vanshika, you tell me. You tell me. I have given you so many ideas. How does the guru manage to save his disciples' life? After that, how did he manage? What plan did he make? Those who are physically present in the class but mentally they are somewhere else, they are going to be marked absent by me in class. Those who are not replying. Kirti Singh, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
The guru arrived on the time to save his disciple and create a drama. He told the king that it was not an ordinary stake, and whoever went to the stake first would become the king in the next life. The second to die would become his minister. The king wanted to avail himself and of the opportunity. The guru and the disciple were realized. Thus, the guru managed to save the disciple's life.
Which kind of chat is going on? Simran, what are you writing? Simran, unmute yourself. Show me your face first. Is it you or someone else? Simran, show me your face. I know it will be fake ID. Simran, you show me your face. Simran, you are being removed by me. So the question is, how does the guru manage to save his disciple's life? Okay. Because he told him, he gave him warning that they were not known to this thing, that what will happen in future. Okay. So here is a very good method that he found.
Yes.
Okay, Arzu, you show me your face. Arzu, You show me your face. There are so many fake IDs. Okay. Now you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. The guru knew that his king and his ministers were fools. In order to save his disciple, guru, he made the plan. He said that the first one to be executed at a stake would become the king in the next life, and the second to be executed would be the king's minister.
Okay. But elaborate this with more examples.
Okay, ma'am.
Divyanshi, you tell me. Now time has. Now we will continue this class tomorrow.